How are you? Do you know any sinusoidal oscillators? There is an electronic circuit which generates a square wave is multivibrator. It is so called multivibrator because the output vibrates between two states. An stable multivibrator is generally a two-stage amplifier with output of one feedback to other. That is, two transistor amplifiers are cross-coupled. There are three types of multivibrators: a stable multivibrator, monostable multivibrator, bistable multivibrator. Today we will discuss about a stable multivibrator. In this multivibrator, when one transistor is in saturation, other will be in cutoff and vice versa. It is a free-running oscillator which does not require any input. It has two quasi-stable states. Let us see the experimental setup of transistor a stable multivibrator. This is the circuit diagram of a stable multivibrator. In this circuit, we can observe resistors. As collector resistors, we are using 1 kilo ohm resistors. As base resistance, we use 100 kilo ohm resistors. To adjust the time constant of the circuit, we are using 100 microfarad capacitors. As this is a transistor multivibrator, we are using two transistors. These two transistors are BC547. In this transistor, this is the emitter terminal, this one is base terminal, and this one is collector terminal. Here, to observe the transistor on and off conditions, we are using LEDs at collector terminals. These are the two LEDs. To demonstrate the stable multivibrator, we have to make circuit connections as per this circuit diagram. These are the two transistors we have connect in such a way that these are emitter base collector of transistor T1 and collector base emitter of transistor T2. To the collector of T1, I am connecting LED. To the anode end of LED, I have connect 1 kilo ohm resistor. To the one end of collector, I am connecting capacitor 100 microfarad. To the other end of the capacitor, I am connecting base resistor of 10 kilo ohm. To the collector end of the transistor T2, I am connecting another LED. I am connecting collector resistor positive end of the LED. I am connecting the capacitor between RB and collector terminal of the transistor T2. This is the RB resistor. I am connecting negative end of the capacitor. Now I connect both the emitter terminals to the ground. Now I am cross coupling the two transistors. Now I am giving the power supply from the RPS. The all resistor ends are connected to the positive terminal of the RPS and the negative terminal is grounded. Now we have to apply sufficient voltage to the circuit. So I am adjusting 9 volts to the RPS. Now we can observe any one of the transistor conduct rapidly than the other. This is because no true transistors will have same parameters like beta and VB. We can observe that the LEDs are glowing when the respective transistors are in on condition. The LEDs are not glowing when the respective transistors are in off condition. Now we can observe the on and off conditions of the transistor in the CRO. Now I am connecting CRO between the collector and emitter terminals of transistor 1. This is the voltage across the collector terminal of the transistor T1. When the transistor T1 is in on condition, we get the nearly 0 volts, and the transistor T1 is in off condition, we get maximum voltage. To observe the base emitter voltage of the transistor T1, I am connecting CRO. This is the base emitter voltage. This base emitter voltage is positive. The transistor is in on condition. At this time, the collector voltage is nearly zero. When the base emitter voltage is negative, the transistor T1 is in off condition. We get the maximum output at the collector. Now to observe the collector voltage of the transistor T2, I am connecting CRO at collector and emitter terminals. This is the output voltage across the collector of the transistor T2. This is the output voltage across the collector of the transistor T1. Now we can observe switching action, that is, the transistor T1 is in on condition, T2 is in off condition. When the transistor T1 is in off condition, T2 is in on condition. Now to observe the base emitter voltage of transistor T2, I am connecting CRO. This is the base emitter voltage of transistor T2. When the base emitter voltage is positive, then the transistor is in on condition. Observe the collector voltage is nearly zero. If the base emitter voltage is negative, then the transistor T2 is in off condition. Then we will observe the maximum voltage at collector of T2. If we observe the collector voltages of both the transistors, we can find. If we observe output of any collector, we get square wave. By this we can understand that an unstable multivibrator is a square wave generator.